Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel. It has been a month since I had uploaded a video, so I really missed you guys. Since I was preparing for my taxation module exam for a CPA here in Canada, but I still having my investing and swing trading for the last month, and I had made a big mistake in the month of December, maybe because on the focus issue. And my biggest mistake was happened last December 17, last week, when I did my biggest trading mistake as I swing my PSTH, some of my next tech, MindMed, and the remaining shares of Airbnb and 44 shares of NEO in favor of OCG. It was a speculative trading as I would love, or I am anticipating, that OCG would move like Wonong Net Technology. WNW, which currently trading at $53, surged during that day to as much as $154. On the other hand, OCG had increased to over 100% after closing on December 16 at $6, ramping to 14.99 at the open. I get in at $16.11 with 139 shares. It continues to go up since I made another market order for 170 shares, swinging 1,000 shares of MindMed. The stock is halted and it was filled at $23 because of greediness. Yes, it touched $25, but just the blink of an eye, the stock went back to earth, dropping to $21, $19, $14, and then closed at $7.33. It was a heartbreaking, losing around $7,000 on that day, or $6,000 as of today, knowing that I had sacrificed my pieces for a chance to earn big, targeting the selling price of $50. But fate moved to opposite direction. Although it is a paper loss and I was already playing with my house money, a victory on the swing trade would mean an early Christmas. It's okay though, you can't win at all. You win some or you lose some, especially on a speculative place, which I did on this stock as I wasn't able to research the company beforehand. Finally, I had a time on research last Thursday evening, Friday, and all over the weekend. On my research, I found out that Oriental Culture Holding Limited is not a bad investment after all. The company as of June 30, 2020 has a strong balance sheet with current ratio of 11.07. No debt, which is their debt to equity ratio is 0.08. Well, total asset ratio is 13.42. This ratio signifies that the company has a strong liquidity position and very solvent. So we can assure, we retail investors and other investors can assure that this company could stand, could continue ongoing concern, not just 1 year, 2 years, but for long years. And it has the possibility to scale out or continue their growth plans, having a less working capital requirement. Meanwhile, it has been profitable for 6 months in the June 30, 2019. Oriental has net income of $6.27 million on a revenue of $7.7 million at a gross profit of 92%. Though revenue had down sharply to $2.37 million in 6 months in the June 30, 2020 due to the effect of COVID-19's lockdown in China, being a non-essential product or services. However, it still have a magnificent gross profit margin of 84%. For me, that is huge. In my point of view, Oriental operates more than like an e-commerce platform, as the company calls itself as digital asset or artwork exchange, in which it provides a platform, an electronic trading platform for cultural and art collections like coins, stamps, painting, among others. And personally, I love art. Note further that it does not participate in cultural and art collections transactions as a buyer, buyer's agent, or seller's agent. Therefore, it only acts as a market or a bridge of the buyer and the seller, just like a stock exchange, making working capital requirement quite lower than the typical e-commerce company, as it do not maintain any inventories. Look at their balance sheet, no, zero inventories. The balance sheet, the current asset, only composed of cash, accounts receivables, short-term investments, and other receivables and prepaid expenses. Look at that their fixed assets, the property, plant, and equipment, is only 399 as of June 30, 2020. Because it is an e-commerce, it gives a software, an online platform, then it invests more on intangible asset, which is 658. Accordingly, OCG revenue stream is driven by listing fees, transaction and marketing fees. Henceforth, when we are back to normal, the company would earn higher revenue, which would be a catalyst to share price increase. Another catalyst to SP movement as well is when they improve their IT or information technology infrastructure. While their plan of expanding to United States after this pandemic, which is not impossible given that they have that resources, they have that huge cash balance, could make the share price to increase further. With that being said, choosing to invest long-term to this company would offer high return, as the company has the niche in this industry and has the growth plan and the resources to perform them or to execute those scale plan. With an offering of more than 140 types of collectibles and artworks valued at more than 5 billion yuan, which is actually 20% to China's 100 billion yuan collectible market. So look at that, the market share of Oriental. So, bottom line, should you buy OCG? At this point, a newly IPO stock, this one is a very speculative and risky because it is a Chinese company and their financial statement might not be audited by PICO. And of course, as a newly listed company, this is also volatile. But to me, this is an excellent value play, showing or basing it to their financial statement. Strong balance sheet, profitability, and good cash flow, and competitiveness, and the potential of their market. However, if you choose to invest on this stock, at this current price of $6, it is a good value, as I said earlier. But you may choose to wait below $6 or around $5.50 so you can have the best entry point. Personally, I have an average cost of 12.66 on my TFSA and 7.05 on my RRSP, or an average cost of $12.14. I already set a sell order of $14. Both to my TFSA and RRSP. It will change or subject to change depending on management's plan and PR releases. So talking about management plan, I'm looking forward to their first earnings report. In addition, I might swing half of my position to THBR, which is merging with Indy Semiconductor, which I believe a strong buy below $15. If you want to know my reasons and investment thesis of this business combination, particularly on Indy, then wait and see you on my next video. That's all for today, guys. So if you like this video and you find it helpful, please click the subscribe button and click that notification bell so you'll be keep updated on my upcoming videos. So if you also want to have more videos like this, click that like button because it means too much to me, so you can help this channel to grow and show me your support as well by having your comments on your reactions at the comments below.